Thank you for joining us here at Doctor's Nutritionist. Today, I'm sure you've had your cholesterol checked. We're going to be talking about how to dig a little deeper into something called an NMR.
Yeah, it's an NMR Lipoprofile.
Exactly.
Your normal cholesterol test is really an outdated test. It is.
It was started back in the 70s, mm-hmm. late 70s. So, you know, and goodness gracious, we've advanced a lot since the 70s.
And we still have some of our panels that have the normal cholesterol mm-hmm. on it to keep the price down, and people, you mm-hmm. know, that are young and don't quite need it yet. Or, you know, we still do the test, but it is an outdated test. And if you're really worried about cardiovascular disease and you really want to know if your cholesterol that you have is the bad kind, the good kind, whatever, then you do need to do the NMR Lipoprofile.
Exactly. And that's what we're going to be talking about here today, is that Lipoprofile. You've got, you know, fairly high LDL, which they're going to call the bad cholesterol. And then they're going to say the HDL is the good cholesterol. Actually, we only have one kind of cholesterol. We just have different carriers.
Right.
And the key with this NMR Lipoprofile is we can look at those carriers.
Right.
We can see them. We can measure them.
What this test measures, mm-hmm. and it's actually, you can think of it as like an MRI for the blood, where it can actually look and go into detail on other things. It's going to give you a LDL particle total.
Mm-hmm.
It is going to tell you your LDL particle small, like the small particles. It's going to give you your HDL particles.
Now, let's talk about that particle for just a second, because yep. they've heard us talk about this particle here for a couple of minutes now. Particles are how the cholesterol is actually moved around the body. The cholesterol starts out as a VLDL. It's a very low-density lipoprotein. And that lipoprotein is not just cholesterol, because your HDL is not just good cholesterol. It's other stuff, too. So is the LDL is not all just bad cholesterol. It's, they call it lousy. I always hated that, because it's very necessary for life. But when you look at that, you know, and she talks about these particles, think about them as little trucks. And these little trucks, because if you think about our blood's basically water, cholesterol's fat, they don't mix, do they? No. So we have to have a way to move it from the liver out to the body, get it to the tissues where it can be used.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where these little lipoproteins come in. They're little trucks that pick up that cholesterol and other fatty stuff, things that we need to use for cell membranes, things like that. You know, triglycerides for energy, et cetera, and they move them around, float around in the blood till it gets to the cells where it can dock with a cell and then offload that contents into that cell.
Right. Now, if you think about it, you can take two people with the exact same amount of cholesterol,
mm-hmm.
but their particles could be vastly different.
Yeah.
And that's what you have to look at, because it's thought that it's not the actual cholesterol that causes the problem. It's the actual particles, and
it
especially
is.
The little bitty small ones.
Well, if you think about that particle, and let's just kind of get you something to visualize here. Think about a basketball. Well, that's a big fluffy particle. It's a basketball. Pretty good size. Now, think about, and that's what we call the big fluffy particles. Now, the small dense particles, think about a golf ball. I mean, if we throw a basketball at you, you can kind of bounce it off and it doesn't really cause any particular problem. Let me hit you with that golf ball. It'll hurt. And it also hurts the tissues floating around in your bloodstream, all that stuff, the vascular endothelium, the lining of your blood vessels and so on, all that can get damaged with those small particles. And it can fit into places where it really shouldn't be.
Right, because they're actually really small.
Real
so we're going to get on this NMR a total particles, how many particles you have,
mm-hmm.
and then we're going to have how many small particles do you have. I do see some people that might have a lot of particles and they have no small ones,
mm-hmm.
and that's actually a better case scenario than people that have high particles and have really high small particles. Now, HDL particles, you know, HDL is one they always say is protective, but just because you have high HDLs does not mean that you have high HDL particles.
Right.
And we see a lot of people that think that their HDLs are very protective, and they're not, because their HDL particles are low.
It's called a dysfunctional HDL.
Right. So again, it gives you a lot more information. So you're going to get the information on the particles. You're going to get the particle, how many small ones. And then we're going to get the LDL size. That's the actual cholesterol itself, and actually how big are the LDLs. You want the big fluffy ones. Again, mm-hmm. big fluffy is better. little bitty small dents is not good.
Yeah, they actually classify it on the test as a pattern A, which is big and fluffy, and a pattern B, which is small and dense.
Right.
And so you want to be pattern A.
You want A. Mm-hmm. So it's going to give you that information. Now, it is going to give you your total cholesterol, your LDL, your HDL, and your triglycerides. So it is going to give you the things that people are used to seeing on a cholesterol test, but then it's going to give you the extra things of the particles and the particle size. And then it's going to take in all this information into account, and it's going to give you an insulin resistance score. It's called an IR score.
And that's something that, you know, we've watched a lot, because when we do, obviously, when we do a big panel on, say, for instance, somebody for a cardiovascular workup, you know, we're going to look at how insulin resistant they truly are. So we go into in depth, like, you know, fasting insulin, et cetera, et cetera. And believe it or not, that insulin resistance score on this lipoprotein profile is really accurate.
It is. It's actually pretty. It really is good.
It's real good.
And it takes in all this information to the count. When you're talking about triglycerides, now triglycerides, that is on your regular test as well, but that is a huge cardiovascular risk.
Yeah.
And if you look at who has the bad particles, it's normally the people with the high triglycerides. Normally. You can't say everybody. Mm-hmm. I have so many people that come in that they've done cholesterol tests. It's a hair high, not even much. I mean, they don't have any other cardiovascular risk. And their doctor's wanting to put them on statin drugs. And the person says, how do I know if I really need to take something to lower my cholesterol? And I always say the first thing is you need to do an NMR lipoprofile. Exactly. Because if you do that lipoprofile, we can actually see where are your particles, where are your, you know, and if it is somebody that really shows no risk and they don't have any of the other symptoms, many times they have normal particles, they have no small particles, and they have really good HDL particles. So in that case, you would say, I personally don't think that you need to lower the cholesterol. Because cholesterol is something that is essential for life, like you mentioned before, and you do need it for the brain. Not all cholesterol is equal. Mm-hmm. And we're not ones that say, oh, you never want to worry about cholesterol, because that's not the case either. And you take these people with the extreme high particles, the really high small particles, the terrible triglycerides, and a high insulin resistance score, they are at high risk for stroke or heart attack.
They truly are. Mm-hmm. And if you once you discover that you have these risk factors, now you can do something about it.
Right.
That's
and
the key.
Like I said, we have people that have come in and they look terrible in an NMR, and we can make that NMR, you know, just about normal in some people. Now, like I said, everybody's a little different and everybody responds differently to natural medicine. And in most cases, we can help most people get it under control. So that's why we think an NMR is way better than a regular cholesterol test. And that's why if you are worried at all about your cholesterol, you need to see an NMR and get more information about it.
No doubt about it.
Mm-hmm.
So be sure and hit that subscribe and that like. That always helps us out. And we'll see you on the next video where we'll be talking about some more risk factors.
We're going to be talking about a little bit going in further in this. Oxidized LDL.
Oh,
so you have
goodness.
Your LDL, but now we're going to talk about lipoproteins, and we're going to talk about oxidized LDL, which goes a little step further.
It's going to get deep.